the flower grows. The moment the feather, you're gonna fly to the moon via Chokeslam Express.
Welcome back to Saturday Night. You know, over the past couple of weeks on the main event, we've been following a man who used to be a wrestler and is now apparently a man of the street, Diamond Dallas.
Well, I tell you what, Tony, you know, Diamond Dallas had it all. He had the ladies, he had the money, jewelry, lost it all, booty man, in a loser leave WCW, then was found by this young man, I guess trying to win a Pulitzer Prize, if you will, taking documentary tape of him ripping people off, begging on the street. Big man on the street, Diamond Dallas Page, surely went from the penthouse all the way down to the, ooh, you know what I'm talking about.
Exactly what you're talking about. As a matter of fact, once again, a tape received from Frank Lechuga, college student, as he takes a very close look at one very distraught Diamond Dallas.
Frank Lechuga here. Thank you very much for the hat. I've got some more footage for you, pulled it together. It's definitely Diamond Dallas this time. This guy apparently will do anything to hustle a buck except earn it. Let's take a look. Look at him. What's that?
Yeah, man.
A cigar butt.
Oh, no way! He put it in his mouth.
Wow, perfect hey. Colors. Hey. Yeah. Okay. This guy cleaning windows in the rain. I'm gonna set you guys up right, man. Okay. I know, I'm gonna set you up right, man. I'm gonna make this look really good.
Cleaning windows in the rain.
Look like that wrestler again.
Who? Oh. Hey, man, don't be playing around, man.
Diamond, who?
What's that stuff right here?
No way, man.
Okay, baby.
No way.
Well, that'd be $5, man.
$5? Are you crazy?
Crazy? I said $5.
$5?
Give me $5.
Yo,
bucks.
Oh, it is him.
Give me $5.
Give him 20. Here, take 20. It.
Well,
man, he's crazy.
Nice you.
This man is
I
crazy.
I really appreciate your hospitality.
I didn't even do my window good. It took my $20.
What a low life.
Getting physical, man. Hey, there's a cop here.
Here they come.
Oh, they got him now.
I saw him do this several times throughout the course of the day. Last time I saw him, he was heading down an alley. I'll try and catch up with him. See you then.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is set for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied to the ring by Kimberly the Booty Babe from the Big Apple, New York City.
Washing windshields now for money?
Well, I'll tell you what, you take a look at Kimberly, the Booty Babe right here with the Booty Man. That's where it started. We were there, uncensored. Loser had to leave WCW. Dallas had done lost it all, including lovely Kimberly, now the Booty Babe. You know what I'm talking about? Dreams, money, everything. Bottom line now, on the street, out on the street.
Diamond Dallas, our thanks once again to college student Frank Lechuga. Hope he enjoys his hat. And,
his what?
His hat, his WCW hat. And thanks for keeping up with the destruct, as you would say, Diamond Dallas.
Yes.
His opponent from Biloxi, Mississippi, Ted Allen.
All right, Ted Allen, the opponent for the Booty Man. No denying the ability of the Booty Man as we take a look at Ted Allen. Certainly an exciting wrestler, a very talented man. And he's rebounded quite well from the attack by Ric Flair and Jimmy Hart not too long ago.
And shown to be a real ally to Hulkamania in what's going on in that situation there with the past match and all them Dungeon of Doom is right here. Booty Man really been on fire lately and really been doing a streak like a comet across WCW. Red Lane right here. Hey, taking a hardcore look at the pay-per-view of pay-per-view Slamboree. The matchups, Tony,
yes, sir.
They're just unbelievable. And how we're going to get to that point, because so important, the winner will come out and face the World Heavyweight Champion in June at the Great American Bash on pay-per-view. But first, Slamboree got to get on.
Scotty Steiner will team with the Booty Man against,
yes,
Rick Steiner and the Pit Bull Sergeant Craig Pittman. You talked about the ally of Hulkamania. You know that Hulk Hogan will be watching closely as Ric Flair and the Giant do battle with each other on WCW Monday Nitro, 7 o'clock Eastern Time this Monday. The great Hulk Hogan, a couple of weeks ago, taking on two men, being successful, defending the honor of the Booty Babe when the Booty Man was down. A couple of knee lifts that time. Here comes the Booty Man. Gonna make it three with a high knee to the face.
Hook him up.
One, two, three. The Booty Man quickly dispatched with Ted Allen.
Yes, he did. And he looked good. And she looked better. She looks better than he does.
Well, she looks darn good.
She looks good. Yes, you know, because you're a golfer. All you do, when we on the road, what? If Lois would listen, is golf. You're a golfer.
You're not golfing. You're not golfing at her.
If that was an Olympic golfing championship, you would have it. I'm gonna call Billy Payne and see if I can get that put in for the Olympics. Golfing.
Let's take a look at the Pit Boys Power.
Is that the magazine you don't have?
Let's take a look at the Pit Boys Power Pin of the Week. And with our power pin, here's the American Dream.
Well, I'll tell you what, he gave him the high knee right here. Not only once, but on two different occasions, and drilled him right under the chin. And the booty man, go ahead and hook that leg up, get the 1-2-3 on WCW Saturday night with a big boy play.
The power pin of the week brought to you by Pep Boys, America's automotive superstore. Everything but gas. Back with more after this.
Why are you making me big and you're bad? Well, this funny night, Joe. You're separating us, and you're in our world. You see, it's a call of the wild boys. Come down to Donbass. We'll make you famous.